ourselves, we might as well.
Yeah, of course. Okay, hands over to
oh, the buzzing of the bees and the cigarette trees, the soda water fountain, where the lemonade springs and the bluebird sings in that big rock candy. On a summer's day in the month of May, a burly bum come a hiking down a shady lane near the sugar cane. He was looking for his life. As they strolled along, he sung a song of a land of milk and honey, where a bum can stay for many a day, and he won't need any money. Oh, 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 where the lemonade springs and the bluebird sings in that big rock candy mountain. In the big rock candy mountain, the cops had wooden legs, the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, the barns are full of hay. I want to go where there ain't no snow, where the sleet don't fall, and the wind don't blow.
ripped off her clothes and shoes and broke her combs, grinding them underfoot, breaking bowls and banging pots.
Death is coming! Death is coming!
Look what you've brought! You killed him! He's never been more!
She ran into the field so that she could no longer hear their voices. Her body pressed against the earth. Her own land no more. Her body seized. Her head and knees against the earth. Without home, without companions, in eternal cold and silence. But the pain of the child seized her. Before the spasms could stop her, she ran to the pigsty. She remembered the old-fashioned women being burnt in pigsties to fall with jealous, pain-being gods who do not snatch piglets. She may have gone to the pigsty as a last act of responsibility. She would protect this child as she had protected its father. Towards morning, she carried the baby towards the well. Probably a girl. There's more hope and forgiveness for boys.
Thank you. Margaret, Margaret, don't you lie to me. Tell me, where do you sleep last night? Come on and tell me somebody. In the ponds, where the sun don't ever shine. I'm a sure. Oh, night, give it for me now.
Drops over impossible. raccoon got to ride in the baskets because he was thin and light. He liked doing it best barefooted. The basket used to twirl and swing, and he could see the whole world laid out beneath him. Neighboring baskets used to come close, and he and the gentleman in the next basket would look each other in the face, and they laughed.
He worked carefully, placing explosives into holes in the cliff edge. One time, two men were killed. One stunned or killed by an explosion fell silently, the other screaming, his arms and legs struggling.
Building bridges was safer. No explosives, only hammering. That's when they get to have fun. Look at me, said Agoon. Look at me. I'm a waterfall, as he sprayed over the side. Then one beautiful day, in a different valley, not the desire to urinate, but sexual desire, took hold so hard that Agoon leaned over the basket.
I'm fucking the
country. Did it hurt? Did I cry?
laughed over his shoulder and winked.
We must prepare you to meet the queen.
Let us help you up with your arm, please.
The less you struggle, the less to hurt.
Two captains sat on his chest, while a third held down his head. They pulled his earlobes taut and jabbed a needle through each of them. They bent his toes so far back that his arched foot cracked. They strung his raw flesh with silk threads. They squeezed each foot so tight, breaking many tiny bones along the sides. Toes gathered, toe over toe over toe. Bandages bound so tight that he wept with the pain. For months they fed him on women's food. Chicken wings to make his hair shine. Vinegar soup to improve his wound. Every night they unbound his feet. But the pain of the blood rushing back into them hurt him so much that he begged for the bandages to be put back on. One day, they placed jade studs into his ears. They attached his feet to shoes that curved like bridges. They plucked each hair from his face. They painted his face white and his cheeks and his lips red. He was ready to serve a meal at the Queen's court.
Unravel.
I would tie the tassels into an end. suppose I'd like a finished border. I could press the fibres down and sew them down. Or cut them off.
This won't do. You say this girl is $100. I'll give you 50.
$100 and I'll throw in a toddler.
My mother-in-law asked me to find her a weaver. A weaver? We will obviously have to spend many months training this girl. Just cut them off.
But she can cook and she can sew and she can find lost watches. What more would you want from a girl?
A weaver? I cook and sew and find things. How else do you suppose I come up with such ingenious questions?
Fine. $80.
50.
18 is a bargain. I won't go any lower.
Very well. Good day, sir.
All right!
$50. Take it.
Good man. I'm a doctor. I'll train you to be my nurse.
Doctor, you do understand I do know how to finish up a weaving?
Yes. We fooled him very well, didn't we?
Mother, what happened to your slave when you came to America?
I found her husband.
How much did you pay to buy her?
$180.
How much did you pay the doctor and the hospital when I was born?
$200.
Oh.
That's $200 American money.
Was it $180 American money?
No.
How much was it in American money?
$50. That's because she was 16. 10-year-olds were $20, 8-year-olds were 10 and up.
thrown inside me a list of 200 things that I had to tell my mother so that she would know the real things about me and stop the pain in my throat.
Oh!
has not called me that for years. A weight lifts from me. The quilts must be filled with air. The world is somehow lighter.